We already know that we might have passed peak oil. So to dig more and more oil out of the ground, gas, coal, etc., we're going to run out of them eventually. If we don't start thinking about alternatives now, when we start running out, we're going to be stuck. Agave is actually a cactus. It's a desert plant, so it's used to growing in hot and dry conditions. And it is about 10 times more water use efficient than other crops that we can think of. This is a real advantage in the northern parts of our state where rainfall is not so reliable. It's also something that stores sugars in its leaves and its stem. So it's more we're more familiar with it because it's used to make tequila. But we like to make it into a biofuel instead. What we're doing is we're doing a chemical analysis to try and work out how much sugar's there and how we can get at it and how well the yeast can ferment it into the fuel that we're interested in at the end. The benefits of using biofuels are that we can recycle materials that essentially we don't use now, so we can be less wasteful about the resources on the planet. It's about mitigating climate change because these plants that are growing now will fix carbon dioxide. When we use them, that carbon dioxide will be released and then you have essentially no change in the carbon dioxide balance. What we really need to do is to get industries and the government interested in biofuel. This is an industry that could take off in Australia. We've got a massive amount of land to grow biomass like agave, and we could become self-sufficient, you know, if you could think about that in the future. Wouldn't that be a wonderful thing that we could do? I am Associate Professor Rachel Burton at the ARC Centre of Excellence in Plant Cell Walls at the University of Adelaide.